the Mekong River Explained in under 3 minutes. The headstream of the Mekong River starts off in the San Jian Yuang National Nature Reserve, which is also the birthplace for Asia's longest and second longest river, with the Yangtze and the Yellow River. All three start their flow less than 500 kilometers away from the Mekong, but end up taking completely different courses through Southeast Asia. After leaving the Tibetan Plateau, the Mekong passes through the Three Parallel Rivers area, where it flows between the huge Yangtze and the Salween River, with spots as narrow as 75 kilometers between the three rivers. After the three great rivers diverge, the Mekong River goes on to be used as an important border marker between the Southeast Asian nations of China, Myanmar, Thailand and Laos, with an over 850-kilometer long stretch between Thailand and Laos. After passing through Cambodia and Vietnam, the 4,350-kilometer long journey through a total of 6 countries comes to an end in the South China Sea. The Mekong River is the foundation of the livelihood of over 60 million people living along its banks in the lower Mekong Basin countries of Thailand, Laos, Cambodia and Vietnam. It supplies 25% of the world's freshwater fishery, boasts the second most biodiverse fish habitat in the world after the Amazon River, and the sediments which are flowing down the Mekong are the fuel for agriculture in Asia's rice bowl, one of the most productive regions in the world. The ecosystem and presence of resources in the Mekong River is not a given, however, and geopolitical issues are on the rise. Roughly the first third of the Mekong River lays in China, and since they control the entire upper stream of the river, all countries of the lower basin are dependent on China's goodwill to not weaponize the water against them. Since 1995, China has already constructed 11 large-scale hydropower stations along the Mekong, which disturb the migratory patterns of fish and reduce agricultural yield downstream by reducing the volume of sediments from the Himalayas, which reach the delta. After a large-scale drought in 2016, China released emergency water flows from one of its dams. But there's no guarantee that China will always show this level of empathy without demanding something in return. It is not just China, though, who wreaks havoc with their mega projects. Laos also dreams and actively works on constructing a series of dams, much to Cambodia's and Vietnam's displeasure. These dams are supposed to lift the landlocked country out of poverty and bring in foreign currency from electricity sales to Thailand and China. While they may function as a stepping stone to industrialization for Laos, these dams will add even more stress to the already weakened ecosystem and political relations of the region. It is clear that these projects are a cause for severe political tensions in the region, so we can just hope that sufficient communication, collaboration and a sense of fairness will lead to a continued growth of the Southeast Asian nations without a severe destruction of the ecology and the livelihood of the millions of people which are calling the banks of the Mekong River their home. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and leave a like if you want to see more like it. Cheers.